So when you go to Paris, you want to see the Eiffel Tower. This is a landmark. When you will go to Egypt, you want to see the pyramids. This is also a landmark. Websites also have landmarks to make it easier for users with screen readers or those operating with a keyboard and a browser extension to move around the website quickly or to find the content they want to find. When you're a sighted user and you want to go anywhere on the site and you have visited it before, all you have to do is just scroll, look at the component you want to find. For example, let's say you want to find the search bar, click it, and there we go. However, when you're using a screen reader, things can get more complicated because you have all these links and buttons and forms, and how do you differentiate which one is the one you want? So this is what landmarks are in a nutshell. They're very useful and they are also in the WCAG, so it is imperative that you use them, but of course you don't overuse them. Here we are on the W3C area landmarks example, and this page is all into landmarks. And if I press this button called Show Landmarks, you can see how on the top we have the banner landmark. This is usually the header if you're using HTML5. The main is using the main element in HTML5 or row main. Navigation is very straightforward. This is just your navigation. Complementary are usually like sidebars, and content info is the footer. And inside the main, you can also have sub landmarks called regions. You can also have forms, and actually if we press on this website right here, you can see we have a bunch of landmarks: banner, navigation, main, complementary, content info, search, form, application. I haven't used this one yet, but you know, it can be useful. One landmark I want to mention is region, which is used if your page is like really cluttered or really long page and there's one section where you want users to go or you think it would be important for users, then you can mark it as a region. So, but we can talk about this later. This is basically what landmarks are. They allow you to quickly jump through content to find what you want to find. So let me show you a real let me show you a real use case example. Here I am on the gov.uk's website, and let's say that I am living in the UK and I want to find a job. So I've decided to go on the gov.uk's website. So to do that, I have to scroll down and click Find the Job link. However, what if I'm using the keyboard? So I'm going to turn on my keyboard. turn on. I'm going to start navigating with the keyboard. Okay, so I'm pressing tab, navigating with the keyboard. I have to go through a lot of links, so it's going to be really time consuming. So if I'm a sighted user operating a keyboard, what I can do is I can actually use this plugin, which is I'm on Chrome and I have installed a landmark navigation via keyboard or pop-up plugin. So I can just click it and click more on .ugov, more on gov.uk region. So this is a region. Remember we talked about regions? Click it and there we go. I can just move to .ue region, move to gov.uk region, press tab. Okay, escape. Press tab. There we go. Find a job. Very easy. But what if I'm using a screen reader? Well, let me show you. Let me turn on my screen reader. I'm going to press Ctrl plus Alt plus N and turn on my screen reader now. So I'm going to turn on my elements list using Insert plus F7.
Elements list dialog.
There we go. Now I'm going to navigate to the landmarks.
Filter by activate button Alt plus A. Tree type. For landmarks radio button checked Alt plus D.
Notice how the landmarks on my NVDA lists all the landmarks right now in the page. So we have the banner, the main, and the main has children landmarks like search, services, information, and then you also have the content. So since I want to find a job, I want to go to more on gov.uk. So I'm going to navigate without using the tab key.
Tree view, filter by, edit, tree view, banner 1 of 3, main, left, more on gov.uk 4 of 4 level 1. Main landmark region more on gov. List with 10 items, find a job link.
There we go. See how easy it was? Because this page is coded properly. So this is one example of you how landmarks are so important. Let's say that I want to go to the footer, okay? I'm going to do the exact same thing. I'm going to press Insert plus F7.
Elements list dialog.
And I'm going to find the content info, which is the footer.
Level 0 content info 3 of 3. Content info landmark clickable coronavirus, COVID-19. Heading level 2 list coronavirus.
There we go. It's very, very easy to navigate if you have landmarks. Not to mention that landmarks also satisfy success criteria on the WCAG bypass blocks, which asks that you not only add skip links, but you have your website added landmarks so that it's easier for people to navigate with them. So here I have written some code to show you how it look, how landmarks looks in HTML5. All you have to do is just use the elements that are provided to provide semantics. Of course, you can also do something like raw banner, but unless you want to target really old browsers and specific technologies, this is redundant and it's not needed. So you just use the HTML5 and you're good to go. So most websites, actually a lot of websites, if they're simple, all they need is just three landmarks: header, main, and footer. That's it. Or basically banner, main, content, info. You don't necessarily have to have all the landmarks in one page. Actually, if you have all the landmarks in one page, unless your page is absolutely very complicated, then if it is too complicated though, you might need to think of a redesign. You have to be really careful with the landmarks because too many landmarks can actually clutter the elements list or the browser extension I showed you earlier and actually make it more difficult for users to navigate the site. Now we have the navigation, which is, you know, very simple. And another thing I want to mention is that if you have multiple navigation elements, because sometimes websites have multiple navigation elements, I want to show you this website, the University of Washington's website. They have multiple navigation because they have navigation here on the top, and they also have utility navigation. So they have they have named all their navigations: audience menu, search and quick links navigation, and main menu navigation. So it's very easy to jump through navigations, but you need to give them a name. And they have done that. So if you have multiple landmarks, for example, multiple navigations, all you have to do is use either area labeled by and connected to a root element. For example, if you have a navigation in the footer, usually they have headings. So they have heading number 2, you know, social links. Then what you do is you add an ID to this code. Let's add an ID to the heading. Let's call it social. And then you reference the ID in the area labeled by code social. And this way you can differentiate between the different navigations like we saw in the University of Washington's website. So for this one, for example, let's say that this is the header menu. So header menu usually don't have headings. So instead of area labeled by, you're going to use area label and say main. There we go. So there's no need to add the name of the landmark inside the area labeled by, because otherwise the screen reader will just repeat itself. So just add main and screen reader will say main navigation or social navigation. And there we go. So the area label or area labeled by. Area labeled by is preferred, but if there is no visible heading or no visible text you can reference, then you can use area label. And that goes for a lot of other landmarks as well. Let's say that you have regions. So we have two row legion, diff row region and section row legion. Actually, section does not need a row legion. If you want to make a section a region, you don't need row legion for that. All you have to do is just add an area label or area labeled by. So let's say that we have jobs for the first one, but the second region have a different. You can only name landmarks the same if they have the same content. But if they have the same content, it doesn't make sense. So you basically would need to do that except for navigation, because sometimes you have navigation in the header and in the footer that is absolutely the same. Then you name the navigation the same name if they have the same links. Okay. So let's say this is jobs, but maybe the second region have programming jobs. So I'm going to name it programming jobs. So and this way users can jump with screen readers or browser extensions very quickly. One thing I have to mention is you don't have to give an area in fact, do not give area label to every section element in your page unless you want it to be a landmark. I have seen a lot of programmers make that mistake. They add sections and they add them area label, because the minute you add an area label to a section, it gives them semantics and it can clutter. I have seen websites with like 10 or 20 sections that are actually regions. And it just clutters so much the screen reader, and it is just a bad experience. So don't do that. There's also the aside, which is the complementary row, and there's also the form. Now, form doesn't have any rows by default. Form doesn't have the row search by default, so you have to add the form search if, of course, the form contains a search. And that's pretty much it. Now, these landmarks are called top-level landmarks because they have to be. They can only be children of the body element, whereas the section has to be a child of another landmark. But these are the top level ones. Whereas nav, of course, you've seen navigations in header so many times. Of course, it can be a child of the header. So these ones are top level. A site is also a top level landmark. The rest of them are not top level, so they can be by themselves. And I want to show you here, if we do show landmarks, you can see how the top level ones are just, they're on their own. So they're only descendant of body. So that's one thing I wanted to mention. And that's pretty much it with landmarks. Use them, make sure all your content is wrapped in landmarks, but also use the region landmarks sparingly. And I've also seen websites where people would add every single link inside a nav. Don't do that too. Make sure that if you have multiple landmarks of the same type, you give them a name with area label or area labeled by, and you're good to go. I forgot to mention that it is also possible to navigate websites via landmarks with screen readers. So now I have turned on NVDA and I'm going to press the D key, which will allow me to navigate the website via landmarks. So let me start pressing D. I'm going to select the website and I'm going to start pressing D.
Banner landmark W3C graphic link. Meta and search navigation landmark list with three items get involved link. Search landmark search. Search edit search.
Remember when we talked about the search landmark and the navigation landmarks? Well, there we go. We're selecting with NVDA.
Main navigation landmark list with six items. Accessibility fundamentals. Main landmark W3C web access. Region making the web accessible heading level 2. Region news heading level. Region C. Region training course. Region web access. Region featured resource. Site content info landmark W3C web access. No next landmark.
If you want to go back a landmark, you press Shift plus D.
Main landmark region. Region web accessibility perspectives video captions heading level 2.
And that's it. And this is the end of the lesson.